type of the transition that takes place in the transition metal complexes is the DD transition. It means a transition that takes place from 1D label to another D label, 1D orbital to another D orbital, that are differing in energies, different energies they have, and such a transition takes place, then this type of transition will be called DD type of transition. And actually this type of transition is the forbidden transition. It means it is not allowed. And how it is forbidden, we will consider it later. As it is forbidden transition, so it appears as a very low intensity band. Example of this type are TiH2O6+3 complex. It is a D1 state, and in this it's, if we see its electronic spectra, there appears one absorption band, that is due to the transition of one electron from 2T2G level to EG level. So the band appears at 22,300 cm-1. Another example we can see NiH2O6+2. This is a D8 state, and in this case there will be three bands in the electronic spectra, and these are due to the transition from 3A2G state to 3D2G state, 3A2G to 3T1GF, 3A2G to 3T1GP. And these appear at the 9,000 cm-1, 14,000 cm-1, and 25,000 cm-1. If you want to see what are these electronic spectra, how we can interpret it, so you can see our videos of Orgel diagram, in which I have described it fully. So you can watch that video. Now, how these transitions are forbidden and the charge transfer transitions are allowed transition. In order to understand this, we have to see the selection rules. There are some selection rules. Actually, we know that when a molecule is radiated, and this is the gap between the two energy levels, and if the light of the same frequency falls on it, then the electron can undergo transition from this level to this level. It may undergo transition, but it is not compulsory that it will always absorb this light. There are some certain conditions which the molecule should have to follow in order to undergo the transition. It will not always undergo the transition by the absorption of radiation. There are certain rules, and these rules are known as the selection rules. So we consider what are the selection rules for the transition metal complexes. The first type of selection rule is the spin selection rule, and according to this selection rule, any transition may occur only between the two energy states of the same spin multiplicity. It means there should not be any change in the spin multiplicity. It means for an allowed transition, the del S should be equal to 0. And if del S, it means the change in spin multiplicity, is not equal to 0, then such a transition will be spin forbidden. Or in general, we can say the spin state of the electron should not change in the course of the transition. For example, if the spin state of two electrons here is such +half, +half, +half. Now, if a electron goes transition from this state to this state, so its spin state should not change. Here it is +half, and here it is also +half. So such type of transition will be allowed. Now see, in this case here, this is +half, and if the electron undergo transition, now if it go in this orbital, it should have to change its spin. It means it will become -half. So it is changing its spin state from +half to -half. So such a transition will be spin forbidden. Or we can say, if a transition takes place from 3T1G to 3T2G, it will be allowed, because in both the cases spin multiplicity is 3. Or if transition takes place from 3T1G to 1T2G, it will be forbidden, because here spin multiplicity is 3 and here it is 1. A general example of it is the complex MnH2O6+2. It is in the D5 state. The metal is in D5 state, so its configuration will be like that. So this is the same condition as I have said here. So in this case, if the electron goes transition from here to here, its spin will change. So such type of transition is spin forbidden. So D5 state is spin forbidden state. Now we see another selection rule, That is Laporte selection rule, and it is also known as the orbital selection rule. According to the electric dipole mechanism, a transition occurs only when there is a change in dipole moment during the course of the transition. It means the dipole moment should be changed, or in other words, if we say in the centrosymmetric molecules, or the molecules which possess the center of symmetry, like the octahedral complexes. In these molecules, all the wave functions are written in the terms of the symbol G or U. For example, the D orbital and S orbital, which are symmetric, centrosymmetric, the symbol will be used G. And in the case of P and F, which are asymmetric type, here the symbol U is used. So according to the Laporte selection rule, a transition from G to U or U to G is an allowed transition. Or if a transition takes place from G to G or U to U, it will be Laporte forbidden transition. So any transition that takes place from D state to P, S to F, P to D or P to S, all of these will be allowed type of transition. And a transition if takes place from D to D, P to P or D to S, then it will be G to G type or U to U type. So these will be Laporte forbidden. So in other words, we can make a conclusion that all the DD transitions are actually the Laporte forbidden transitions. That's the reason these bands, the DD transition bands, are very weak intensity bands, because the DD transitions are the Laporte forbidden transitions. However, this type of transitions takes place. Why this takes place? Because there is the relaxation of the selection rules. These selection rules are relaxed by some of the manner. So these transitions takes place, but at a very low intensity, and appears as a very weak bands. This is due to the relaxation of the selection rule. So we consider how these selection rules are relaxed. Firstly, we see the spin selection rule. How spin selection rule is relaxed? According to the spin selection rule, we know that in the course of transition, there should not be change in the spin multiplicity. But actually what happens? There is spin orbital coupling. We know that spin and orbital momentum couples together. It means S and L couples and gives a new angular momentum J, that is known as the total angular momentum. So now we don't consider the spin or orbital alone. We consider J. So the spin forbidden transition that we see, actually spin forbidden transition, now becomes the partly allowed transition. Now we see the relaxation of the Laporte selection rule, how the Laporte selection rule is relaxed, and it may happen in the two manners. The first way may be the lowering of the molecular symmetry, when the molecular symmetry is lowered, and this happens most commonly in the case of tetrahedral complexes. We know the tetrahedral complexes have no center of symmetry. These molecules have no center of symmetry. So in this case, these G and U terms have no meaning. These are meaningless, and we don't use these terms in the case of tetrahedral complexes. Now, if we consider the terms that are arising from the different orbitals, the 3p orbitals are giving T2 term, and the 3d orbitals that are dxz, dyz and dxy all are giving the same term T2, because here no T2u or T2g are terms are using. So both will give T2 term. Now these two terms can mix together. It means this D and P characters may mix together, or we can say there will be the mixing of the G and U terms. Why? Because this P orbital denotes to U symbol, and this D for D orbital we use the G symbol. So here the mixing of the G and the U terms takes place. So what will happen? G, the orbital that is related to G will have some U character, and the orbital that is U actually will have some G character. Both are mixing. So both the excited state and the ground state will have different extent of G and U character. So what happens? actually we see GG transition, but now it is not a perfect GG transition. It becomes partly G to U type or partly U to G type because of the mixing of the G and U characters, mixing of the orbitals. So the transition that was actually forbidden now becomes partly allowed. So this is the why the intensity of the absorption band of TD type in the tetrahedral field is almost 20 to 120 times more as compared to the intensity of absorption bands of TD type in the octahedral field. It means a TD transition in tetrahedral field is more intense as compared to that in the octahedral field. The octahedral field we observe the bands that are weaker, that will have the less intensity as compared to that in the tetrahedral field, because in this case this transition becomes partly allowed as compared to the octahedral complexes. And this point you should always remember, because there are several questions like this may be asked in the exam and we have to compare the intensity of the two types of complex. So you should notice it, that if a molecule is less symmetric then it will have more intensive band. Or we can consider by another example, if we see two isomers, one is cis isomer and another is trans isomer, we know cis isomer is less symmetric while the trans isomer is more symmetric. So it is less symmetric, so here the relaxation of Laporte selection rule will be more, so it will give more intensive band while it is more symmetric, so it will give less intensive band. So in this case the intensity will be lower and here it will be higher. Now we see the another way in which the Laporte selection rule may be relaxed, and this is the Vibronic coupling, and it makes a relaxation of Laporte selection rule in the case of octahedral complexes. We know that in the course of electronic transition there are vibration, the molecule is also vibrating. So if a molecule vibrates asymmetrically then it may destroy the center of symmetry of the molecule to some extent, and it will result in the lowering of symmetry or the relaxation of the Laporte selection rule. We know that the molecule is vibrating along with the electronic transitions, and the vibrations may be of two type. If it is symmetric with the electronic transition it is called G-type vibrations, or it may be anti-symmetric with the center of symmetry of the molecule, that is called U-type of vibrations. So now there may be mixing of these type of vibrations with the ground state term or the excited state terms. So this mixing of the vibrational and the electronic part of the wave function is actually known as the Vibronic coupling. And as a result of this Vibronic coupling, the actually that was the GG transition now becomes G to U or U to G type of transition, and it becomes partly allowed transition. So in this way the Laporte selection rule becomes partly allowed. So this is all about the different types of electronic transitions and the selection rules. Thank you.